Welcome to Tailgate Sunday, family and friends of Crossover Church. Y'all, it is going down today. We were supposed to be outside grilling, tailgating, but you know what? Inside is going to be just as turned up. We are going to have just as good of a time. But y'all that are at home, you know that you are on your couch and you're just going to watch the service and then you already ready to watch the game later on. But we still want to make sure you guys get your faith and your spirit charged up today, y'all. We're going to have an amazing message, going to have an amazing recording office that's going to be with us today, and baptisms, y'all. I hope you guys enjoy this service from your house. Nothing's different about Tailgate Sunday. Make sure you put your football emojis in the chat. Make sure you put your hands up emojis, all of that. Stay engaged. Let us know where you're watching from and your prayer requests. As always, there's content available for your kiddos on our Kids Ministry playlist on YouTube. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like our YouTube channel. Same thing with Facebook. Like and follow us. Share this live stream, y'all. Week after week after week, you're home, but you still need to invite somebody to church. Share this live stream so that someone is blessed by Crossover's awesome services today, y'all. We're excited. We are so, so excited. Now let's get ready for service today.
That they never could.
So desperately that you're right, yet to fail all the same. Dread it. Run from it. Destiny still arrives.
Evacuate the city. Engage all defenses and get this man a shield.
Fun isn't something one considers when balancing the universe. But this does put a smile on my face.
Church, happy Super Bowl Sunday up in here. Tailgate Sunday. Check it out, y'all. It's going to be an awesome day. We're going to worship God together. Come on, clap those hands. Everybody clap. Everybody clap those hands. Let's go. Come on. Everybody lift it up. Lift it up. Let's go. We got the victory today, y'all. Hey, hey. Here we go. I got the V-I-C-T-O-R-Y. Ladies.
I'm on.
One more time, say, I got the victory. The victory, the victory. I got the V-I-C-T. Somebody who's listening, right now. You feel like you can't win, cause you try. Greater is he that is. Everybody put your hands up, let's go. Lunch day we changed, every day we winning. Sins have been forgiven, died and now we're living. Holy Spirit take over, so the people can hear me. Won't freedom, let the pain go. Jesus, what you came for, victory is here. It's time to let everybody the pain go. Come on, everybody see you. Everybody see you. Everybody say the V-I-C-T-O-I-Y. Let's go. Woo! Check it out, y'all. We're going to celebrate something else today. We have people getting baptized today. Make some noise. If you are getting baptized today, come on. Head on down over here. We're going to celebrate with you. Also, if you want to get baptized today, it's spontaneous. You can come on down, get baptized right over there. My God. Y'all sing it with me. It's been so strong, so mighty. I hear y'all singing. My God, plan for me. Go beyond my wildest dreams. Everybody sing it out, say, come on, let's go, y'all. If you're getting baptized, come on down so right strong. Now. If you want to get baptized, come so on down high. Right now. Let's go, let's go.
My God,
say, say.
Plan for me.
Go beyond
my wildest dreams.
Everybody lift it up, say.
My God,
it's good.
It's good.
So good.
So good.
Today. Sing again, sing my God. Come on.
My God.
Let's go. It's big, say.
It's big.
So strong.
So strong.
So mighty.
So mighty.
My God.
My God.
Plan for me.
Plan for me.
Go beyond it.
Go beyond my wildest.
Come on. Everybody lift it up. Say,
my God.
It's good, yeah.
It's good.
So good. Somebody getting baptized, y'all, right now. Y'all clap it up for them. Hey, hey. We still got room for you. Come on, let's go. Clap it up for him, y'all. Let's celebrate with our brother today. He's my boy. God, he is. Yeah. We still got room for you. You want to get baptized? Come on, let's dance. And there's nothing my God cannot do. Everybody dance it out with a shake.
Everybody lift it up, say,
there's nothing. You can still get baptized. Y'all sing it. Come on, say it. So strong. Today is your day. If you want to get baptized, you can still do it. Doesn't matter if you signed up for it or not. If you want to get baptized, it is your day. You can still come on down and we will celebrate with you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Can we throw those hands up all over the room? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes. Because this is how I find my battles. This is how I fight my battles. Oh, this is how I fight my battles. Yeah, come on, everybody, sing this with me. It may look like, say,
it may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Yeah, that's it. Sing it out.
It may look like I'm surrounded, but
that's it, come on, everybody sing it out.
It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Everybody sing it out, say
it.
This is how I fight.
This is how I fight.
This is how I fight. Yeah.
This is how I fight my battles.
Come on, say it. It may look like.
It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Oh my God, it may look like.
It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Yes, it may look like.
It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Yes,
God, it may look like.
Lift it up in Spanish. Aunque bella, say.
Aunque bella, que estoy rodeado de ti.
Aunque bella,
que estoy rodeado de ti.
Aunque bella,
I see the Leo. I see the Leo. I see the Leo. I see the Leo.
battles right here. This is how I fight my battles right here. Woo!
The weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. 'Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. And my God never fails. Oh, my God never fails.
Come on, let's sing it, say it.
So I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the
battle.
The battle.
You thought I was worth saving, so you came in to change my life. You thought I was worth keeping. Woo! So you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for. So you sacrificed your life so I could be free, so I could be whole, so I could tell everyone I know. You thought I was worth saving, so you came and you thought I was worth keeping. So you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for. So you sacrificed your life so I could be free, so I could be whole, so I could tell everyone I know. And I'm singing so I could be free, so I could be whole, so I could tell everyone I know. And we're singing hallelujah.
Come on, sing it out, say it.
Hallelujah. We sing your glory to the God who changed my life. And I will praise you, I'll worship you, I'll bless your name. Give you praise, I'll praise your name, I'll worship you. You're worthy of the praise, you're worthy of the praise. I'll bless your name, 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 I'm gonna bless your name, I'm gonna bless your name. I won't let no rock cry out in my place. I won't let no rock cry out in my place. I got victory, I got victory, I got victory. Thank you.
Listen, sometimes you don't have to know what people are going through just to praise him for them. There are certain times in worship experiences where you may see somebody doing something and we often wonder what's going on. I encourage you in moments like this, don't wonder what's going on. Praise him for what's going on. It's not a time to sit there and spectate and wonder. I wonder what they're going through. I wonder what it is they're facing. In moments and opportunities like that, begin to praise him for what they're going through. You don't understand it, but your praise can help. It's just like Paul and Silas in the jail, y'all. We talked about it so many times. These brothers began to worship their God until not just their shackles were loose, but everybody's shackles were loose. And when we come together as a corporate body like this, we don't always know what our brothers and sisters around us or in this room are even facing. But did you know that your worship can unlock shackles of people that are right next to you? Did you know that your praise can unlock some shackles of some people right next to you? Did you know that your worship can shake the foundation of people that is right next to you? Did you know that your praise can open up somebody's prison doors that's right next to you? Did you know that your worship can unlock and unleash things in a room that's right next to you? So while you may be sitting there and everything may be fine in your household, and thank God for that, but there may be people in here who are going through some of the toughest times of their lives. And if we truly are like the body of Christ, if we truly are Christ-like, if we truly are Christians, then we ought to be able to praise for them. I ought to be able to praise for you. I ought to be able to give God praise for you. I don't know what you're going through, sister. I don't know what you're going through, brother. But right now, in this moment, I choose to praise God on your behalf. I choose to worship him on your behalf. Let people think you're radical with your praise. Let people think you're crazy with your worship. That's the kind of God I serve. That's all that is. That's just the kind of God I serve. That's just the kind of God I serve. I'm not gonna keep it shackled up. I'm not gonna keep it bottled up. That's the God I serve. Look what he did for me. And if he did it for me, if he did it for me, then he'll do it for you. No more bondage, no more shackles. You are free in the name of Jesus. You are free in the name of Jesus. So Father, we thank you for this moment. We thank you for this opportunity that we had, not just to praise and worship for ourselves, but God, to praise and worship for somebody else, for on somebody else's behalf. We give you everything. You said it, God. You put the breath in our lungs, so we pour it back out to you. But today, God, not just for ourselves, but for our brothers and sisters, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise. We give you glory. You're worthy of it. In Jesus' name, somebody shout amen. Go ahead, air high five, a victory high five. Air high five, a victory air high five as you take your seats. God bless you all.
Hey there, welcome to the Crossover Tailgate Service. I am Pastor Lucy, or how about Coach Lucy for today? Listen, we're so glad that you're here to help us cheer on our very own Tampa Bay Bucks. But first, If this is your first time worshiping with us, then we have a free gift for you. If you're worshiping with us online, make sure you head over to our website, crossoverchurch.org. Click on I'm New, and then we're going to drop a gift in the mail for you. But if you're here at the service with us, simply go to the VIP table after service. It's in the middle of the lobby, and someone there, I guarantee you, someone there is going to be excited to put a gift in your hand. So thank you to our guests who are with us today. Now, we're getting ready to start our next semester of growth groups. Now, what are growth groups? They are small groups of people that are going to meet together and do a Bible study together on different topics for 6 weeks. Most of these groups, they're going to take place virtually on Zoom, but we do have a few groups that are going to take place in person, of course, with safety precautions in place. So we want you to grow. We want you to be in community. We want you to connect with others in and do life with one another. So make sure that you go to our app or our website page to sign up for a group. And if you're interested in maybe leading a group, if you're ready to level up, right, and lead a group, then hit up Miss Rhonda at rhonda@crossoverchurch.org. Now I'm excited because we're getting ready to transform social media from social media to social ministry. Listen, we have thousands of people that are connecting with us online every single week. And we know that most of our crossover family has not yet come back to worship with us in person. But we want you guys to stay involved and stay connected. We don't want you sitting on the sidelines. Why? Because it's game time. Because we need you running with us. We need you tackling with us. We need you to help score touchdowns for the kingdom. Who is with me? Let's go. We've got to do this, and we've got to do this together. So I want us to be able to transform social media into social ministry. So we're looking to build up our online ministry team. So if you're interested in becoming or being part of this ministry, then please register today. Sign up today on our website or using our app so that you can get plugged in and help us transform social media. And last but not least, next Sunday, we're going to start our 3D Growth Track, which is our membership class. It's at 10 a.m. here in the building. Now, this class, you're going to get to know about us, our vision, what we believe and why, and we get to know about you and help you get connected as well. As a matter of fact, we're going to help you discover, develop, and display in 2021. So make sure that you sign up today for our Growth Track. So listen, enjoy your Super Bowl Sunday. And who's with me? Who is with me? Tampa Bay, Tampa Bay, Tampa Bay, Tampa Bay. Let's go.
Yeah, happy Sunday crossover. Come on, clap your hands if you're excited to be in God's house today. For those of you that are worshiping with us online, we're so glad to have you tuned in today as well. How many of y'all are excited about the game today? Come on. How many of y'all don't care? Y'all have other plans tonight. Like, what game? Why is there so much traffic? Why are they shutting streets down? This is foolishness, right? No, it's a big deal, obviously, to be able to make history and be the first team to be able to have a home game for the Super Bowl. And we wanna celebrate that, right? We wanna honor what the Bucks have done and be able to do this season. But we know who the King of Kings is, right? We know who the Lord of Lords is, right? And so we can have fun as believers and still keep our priorities in check. Salute to everybody that has a hand in making our services happen. Can you all take just a quick moment for me really fast and just clap your hands and salute all of our folks that work behind the scenes to help make Sunday happen? Yeah. They get here hours. Everybody say hours. No, y'all didn't say it the right way. Hours. They get here hours. Oh, y'all did good. That was good. That was good. Type hours in the chat, but put a couple O's in there. They get here hours before most people do to help make sure that things are ready and are right to receive you when you show up. And so we're very, very thankful to all of our activators and all of our volunteers to help make things happen. Pastor Lucy alluded to this in the announcement, but let me just emphasize really quickly that our kids ministry creative team is launching an all-new virtual lesson starting today. So you can go to our Facebook Facebook page for the kids ministry, which is Kids Men 813, spelled with a Z, or go to the Crossover YouTube channel, and there's a special playlist that's right there that you'll be able to plug into what they're doing and make sure that our kids are properly taken care of. So come on, y'all, let's salute our kids ministry for working really hard to make sure that's happening. They'll be doing new content every single week, and so very, very thankful for that. Y'all, do y'all know what this Wednesday is? This Wednesday is Pastor Tommy and Pastor Lucy's 25th wedding anniversary. 25 years. They still got some sizzle. Their daughters are in the room. They're probably like, oh, we don't want to think about that. So this Wednesday, we're starting a brand new series called Socially Connected. And I want to invite all of you that have not yet made Wednesday nights a priority. If you really, really want to go to another level in your spiritual walk, you got to be intentional. Everybody say intentional. You got to be intentional. Sunday is not enough. Sunday is great. Sunday is great, but Sunday is not enough. None of us in here will eat one meal per week unless we're fasting. By the way, congratulations for those of you that finished the 21 days of fasting and prayer. Yeah. We heard some testimonies yesterday as we prayed together here yesterday morning, and some people are going extra days. They're going to go extra longer, and that's a blessing and a privilege and an honor, and so we want to commend and salute all of you for sticking it out and for making it work. We want to hear your testimonies. We want to hear what God has done, and so inbox us on social media. Send us an email at info@crossoverchurch.org. We'd love to hear what God is saying to you in that regard. We're going to worship God through our giving now. This is just as critical as our worship through singing and our worship through fellowship and our worship through hearing the word of God. And there's two quick verses that I want to bring your attention to. In 1 Timothy chapter number 6, verse number 10, it says this: for the love of money, everybody say the love of money. For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. Don't let social media fool you. It's not money that's the root of all evil. All right, that's bad theology. It's not money. God does not condemn money. As a matter of fact, in Proverbs it says, money answers for all things. In other words, God uses money to help provide for our needs here on earth. But the love of money, being consumed by it, being mastered by it, is a problem. But watch what Paul tells Timothy. He says, some people eager for money have wandered from the faith and pierce themselves with many griefs. Now think about that for a moment, that there are some folks who are so in love with money that they literally have walked away from God. Think about how powerful that is. They literally have walked away from God because of their love for money. Now, why is that important? Because as Pastor Tommy comes today to talk about winning rhythms, as we're concluding this series today about rhythm, you cannot, please hear me, be in a winning rhythm with God or with your finances when master is your money. I just said something, I hope you didn't miss it. You cannot be in a winning rhythm with God when your perspective and your priorities are out of whack. And so it's really important for us to remember that God has to be more important than our money. Watch this. And how we see money and how we approach money will reflect our faith in God. Here's the second thing I want to tell you really fast. Malachi chapter number 3, verse 10, it says this: bring the whole tithe, tithe means 10, into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that you will not have room enough to receive it. And oftentimes we hear that verse when it comes time for tithes and offerings, and people wonder, why do you go to that verse so much? Why is that verse so significant and so powerful? Because it reminds us that God has a plan for our finances, and it involves his local church. It involves serving his local church through our finances. I can look at your checkbook. I can look at your pocketbook. I can look at your pockets and tell what you prioritize. And that's a reality. And God wants us to make sure that we're already also prioritizing his church. And so we have multiple ways to give here at Crossover. For those of you that may be visiting with us for the first, second, or third time, or those of you that are even online, you're worshiping online with us for the first, second, or third time, you're wondering, well, what is it the deal about this church? Do they walk in integrity? We have external auditors that audit our books. We have a budget. We have the best practices around. We try to honor God with every single penny that comes in. And so you know that we can be trusted, and you know that we're doing things the right way. Somebody say amen to that. So if you look on the screens, there are multiple ways that you can give. Of course, we don't pass the baskets anymore. We want to invite you. Also, you can set up recurring giving. We've been talking about fire starters for a few weeks now. We're going to talk about that in more detail in a few weeks coming. Let's begin to pray together as we get ready to move forward in our worship. Father, thank you for the awesome privilege that we have to give to you, to honor you with our finances. You are our source. Our jobs and whatever income we have is the resource. Our focus, our priority, our hearts are on you. And Father, help us to make sure that we're maintaining a proper perspective on our finances. Help us, God, to be diligent to study the word of God and to adopt the plan of God regarding the finances and the money that comes into our homes and comes into our lives. We thank you in advance that you supply all of our needs. I thank you that we don't have to resort to prosperity theology or a watered down theology, but clearly in your word, you want your children healthy, healed, whole, and blessed. And we thank you for having a plan for our lives. In Jesus' name, everybody said amen. Awesome. Come on, clap your hands for that. Amen. I have the awesome privilege of welcoming back somebody who is not a stranger to our stage. He is known all over the world, literally. He's a multi-nominated, multiple award-winning artist, has been in many states and many countries doing great music, and we're so very thankful that he's a friend of Crossover. Everybody, welcome to the stage, KJ, 5, 2, woo!
Yeah, thank you, sir. Appreciate that. Quick question, how many of y'all like free stuff? Who needs some free stuff this morning? Okay, how many of y'all know the two things that you can depend on in this world is Jesus and your family? Okay, so we need to get on the same page together. I want you to say something for me. It's real simple. You just got to shout it nice and loud. Say this, sis. All I have is Jesus and the family. Shout it. All I have is Jesus and the family. One more time. Hands up. All I have is Jesus and the family. Y'all ain't understand me. I ain't got a plan B. Can you help me find the livest person out there?
Oh, I will.
All right, run that track for me. Here we go. Jesus and family, they'll never fail you. You don't need a plan B. Go ahead and run that whenever you're ready. Turn that way up. Turn it way up for me. If you know that's all you need, raise a hand like this right here. All the way up. Let's go. Let's let everybody know like this.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Shout it.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Come on.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Y'all don't understand
all
me.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Yeah. Now they said I had a wrong religion. And then they said I made a wrong decision. I've been this far, still I'm on a mission. Still I stand behind these bars, kinda like I gone to prison. Yeah. Got a vision, I listen, my Savior, God ain't risen. Yeah. My God is still upon the throne just when you wanna diss him. Yeah. The old me is dead and gone and I ain't gonna listen. Yeah. Yeah. He had it subtract just like his longer vision. Yeah, yeah. Man, they still think I'm kinda odd. I'm a part-time rapper, but I'm a full-time man of God. Woo. You see the rock that I'm standing on? All you ever see is the green like it's camouflage. I got a team, plus I'm standing strong. One hand of you, my other hand's a God. But through it all, I ain't planning to fall. Plus he guides my every move like a dude in Avatar. Now say this.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Shout it.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Tell somebody.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Y'all ain't understand me. I ain't rockin' plan B.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
All you got is.
All I have is Jesus and the family. All I have is Jesus and the family.
Y'all don't understand me. I ain't got a plan B now.
They say that God is in the details.
Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah.
I say that God has taken three nails.
Yeah.
Paid it all upon the cross when he prevailed. When the devil had me locked, now but he failed. Woo! What you see here, I'm just an eyewitness. I'm running back to him just like the line of scrimmage. You can tell me now that I'm finished. You miss these bars kinda like a blind gymnast. Woo! Blind gymnast, man, I can't see. I'm rocking tighter in these pants, bitch.
Yeah.
Cause if I'm silent and I can't speak, I'll be speaking all up in my ears like a hands free. Man, you can slam me, ban me. All I ever have was this, I never drop a plan B. I got no limits to his plans B. All I ever have was what?
Hey, all I got in this life is my squad and the mic that I use to speak into the darkness when I call the light. I got the Holy Spirit, my heavenly Father in Christ that I serve with all of my might, and I follow despite the persecution, this promise. They say this promise is light, but in my past I wasn't scared of a brawl or a fight. What would they change, especially now when God has been right there beside me fighting my battles, even drawn at the sight of my king. I stand taller than God, still a stand, so I'm safe. I feel like Anakin,
King Kong, gorilla hand.
Who lied to Satan and told him that there's still a chance? It is written only the army of God will advance. A plan B would just be man-made, so I'm banking on plan A. You know I can't say. In the face of death, I worship with my hands raised. All I really got is Jesus and my family.
Hands up!
And all I have is Jesus and a family.
Shout it.
All I have is Jesus and a family.
Shout it.
All I have is Jesus and a family.
Y'all ain't understand me. I ain't got a plan B. Never.
All I have is Jesus and a family. All I got is Jesus and a family. All we got is Jesus and a family.
Wait, just the ladies.
Plan,
ladies.
Y'all have Jesus and a family.
Come on, ladies. ladies.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Tell us about it.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Where my fellas at? Shout it out.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Yeah.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Yeah.
All I have is Jesus and the family.
Y'all ain't understand me. I ain't got a plan B now.
Yeah.
Give it up for my man Dayton.
Woo. That was fun.
That's what I'm talking about.
Do we throw it
it's
out?
Like we got some Bucks fans up in the house.
Oh,
real
yeah,
quick.
Yeah, grab that one.
Hold on. Come on, when you see this, what does it make you feel like? We back. It's been a long time, okay? I'm a Tampa boy. I'm so glad we're back. Every day is a game, isn't it? We got to put our game face on, don't we? We live in a world that tells you your faith is dead. No, I'm sorry. My God is very much alive. I got a reason to be excited today. Could we get our game face on together as a body of Christ? Let's do it. Here we go. All right, here we go.
Yeah.
Oh, I got two more shirts.
Yeah, we do.
Back. I'm trying to get up in my zone. It's time to get my game face on.
I say, I'm running hard, I'm up to God, and I love it. I'm about to get my game face on. I said, my game face. All day, a day, all time. Hands up on your head like an avalanche in the diamond mine. You chasing at your dollar sign. I'm chasing at my God and I. Placing my faith up in His grace and I run this race to the bottom line. Game now, I try to find who's down to ride and roll with. Cause I'm game face, I'm here tonight. How you doubting who you be? Cause I'm going in, I'm showing it. What you did and done for me. I know I live, I know our sin is gone. I've been redeemed.
I'm feeling like a beast, someone let me out. I'm feeling like I'm free,
Jesus let me out.
You feeling just like me and someone let you out. Then get up on your feet, it's game time. Let me hear you shout, going in for the win.
Game face,
body full of adrenaline. Turn in my zone, going hard like I'm LeBron. Watch me take it home. In my going in for the win. Body full of adrenaline. Turn in my zone, going hard like I'm LeBron.
Can I get two hands clapping like this? Put it up for the rap and the joke for the cats and the all for the rap and the choco. I'm back in the lap in the back, it's packing the Mac and the pack and the no no. I'm breaking down, shaking down, taking down, make a sound, kinda kinda
fast in the slow mo.
Come on,
going in for the win.
Game face,
body full of adrenaline. Turn in my zone, going hard like I'm the front. Watch me take it home. Going in for the win. Body full of adrenaline.
I'm
feeling like a beast, someone let me out. I'm feeling like I'm free, and
Jesus let me out.
You feeling just like me, and someone let you out. Then get up on your feet, it's game time.
Everybody shout!
Game face!
Let me hear you shout!
Game face!
Let me hear you shout!
Game face!
Wait a minute.
Nah.
Tap it up. Clap it up like Brady just scored. And the game is over. And you won. Now clap it up like your king won. Clap it. Turn it up to the bump and the trump and the back and the bump and the blast and the pump coat. Put it up for the rap and the jump for the cast and the up for the rap and the choke coat. I'm back in the lap. Back in the pack and the back and the pack and the no-dos. Break it down, shake it down, take it down, make it sound
fast and the slow-mo.
Back in the zone, no. Rap is a promo. Not my Jesus, he just sees. Wait a second. What's that say? Come here. Fist up. Let me hear you shout. Buccaneer fans,
one, two,
hear you shout. What's that say right
win.
There?
Game face.
One more time.
Game face.
Going in for the win. Shout.
Game face.
Put your fist up in the air. Shout.
Game face.
Turn in my zone. Going hard like I'm LeBron. Watch me take it home, shout!
Game face.
That's what I'm talking about, that's the game face. But we're making it too easy. We gotta make it a little harder.
A little bit.
I gotta tell my story.
We still got shirts, you know?
Let's take it a little bit back in time. Go ahead and run that next one. I'm gonna tell you the story of a little boy growing up in Ybor City / Palm Harbor, sitting in his bedroom like this. sitting right there. Okay, everybody do this. Remember? You know what?
That's using your head.
I was old school. I reached over to my radio. I turned it on. All of a sudden, this happened. I was like, what's this rap music doing to my Caucasian body right now?
Ooh.
I want you to put your hand up in the air like you washing your car on a Saturday.
Cobra Kai. Right?
When I say switch, you switch. Switch! All right. Right here. You really want to party with me?
Yeah.
How about they get their hands where eyes can see?
Yeah.
Hey, yo, we wildin' in the place to be.
Go on.
Time travel. 1993. Here we go.
Yeah, I heard this is a hip-hop church. Hip-hop parade.
The Bible says, get down, the space of humility. I got on my knees and I said, Jesus, come into my life. And all of a sudden, pick it up, come jump.
Y'all know, it's like a Pentecostal church now.
Jump around.
Hey.
Wait a second, wait a second. When we said to jump around, they didn't all jump around.
They didn't.
We gotta do it again.
Bring it back.
Hands right here. You know it.
Engine, engine number 9 on the New York Transit line. If my train goes off the track, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up.
Let's go. Let's go.
What?
Can I get up?
What?
Ow! Can I get up?
What?
Can I get up?
What?
Can I get up?
What?
Ow! I'm not Florida. I'm old school Florida. I'm talking Miami Bass ride out type but old Florida, okay? Now, if you just moved here, you don't know what I'm talking about. It's real simple, okay? I want you to act like you're in a roller rink and it's 1987. Everybody put your hand out like this. Stop. Look around. Say, I'm gonna do it better than you. Say, no, you ain't.
Left. To the right. To the left.
That's it right there. All right. I used to have a problem with Mountain Dew, and the song went like this.
To the
I said, now, oh, what am I gonna do?
I'm addicted to Mountain Dew.
With a drink like one or two, these people be like,
what's wrong with you?
I'm acting like a fool. Who want the caffeine and the
sugar too?
Meaning like I ain't got a clue. Put your fists in the air, everybody say, say, oh,
give me that Mountain Dew.
Say, oh,
give me that Mountain Dew. Give me that Mountain Dew.
I ain't playing with you. You better give me that. Give me that.
Give me that Mountain Dew.
Oh.
Give me that Mountain Dew. Give me that Mountain Dew. That's bad for you.
All right, do me a favor. You got a phone? Put your phone up in there. Put it up, put it up, put it up. I need to see what you guys are doing. Come on, put it up.
Up in the
put
air.
It up.
Got your hands up in the air. Got your hands.
Turn that light, turn that light up.
In the air.
Yeah.
Got your
yeah.
What I was not. Smile, you on KJTV.
Oh no!
Alright, here we go, here we go.
Right?
Yes, a city boy. Born and raised in.
We're not even in Detroit.
Nope. They're locked down.
Alright, alright. Thank you guys. Go ahead and have a seat. Thank you for humoring me.
Aw.
I wanted to tell you, that's where I was. I was lost. I was just lost in the world, trying to find definition. A misfit, someone who didn't fit. But Jesus stepped in. He gave me hope. He gave me purpose. He told me that I was loved when the world said, you're a mistake. So I want to do this last song and dedicate it to anyone that's ever been told to be written off. Your life is a blank canvas that God wants to paint a masterpiece with. This song is dedicated to you. Go ahead.
Welcome to the Island of the Misfit Toys.
toys. Welcome to the island of the misfit toys. Land of the broken girls and boys.
This is my story. Now I was just sitting in detention, feeling like the Breakfast Club. Stepping out my desk, wishing that I had a hug. I wouldn't pay attention, but what I pay for love. Cause when you searching for that junk, it's kinda like a drug. I was awkward, introvert, really never had a turn. Struggling with my hurt, stomach's all up in a churn. Stomach's all up in a churn, rumbling up in my shirt. Wishing that I had a girl, but all I ever got was burned. They say these nerds gotta wait their turn. Oh, I'm sick, but I'm living in a dream deferred. Heart gripped in pain, mouth full of curse words. I can't get away till I read the first verse of the word. Then I learned that my birth was cursed. Yeah, Jesus died for me and all my net worth. Realized my need just to make my second birth. Bow my knee and I said, take away the hurt. But this is for the misfits, rejects, losers, defects, weirdos, awkward, broke down, strange kids. Don't you forget that you are loved. You are loved. You are loved. Skate kids, emo, straight kids, weirdos, gay kids, losers, broke down zeros. Don't you forget that you are loved. You are loved.
Welcome to the island of the misfit toys. Welcome to the island of the misfit toys. Welcome to the island of the misfit toys. Land of the broken girls and boys.
Goes out to you, brother.
Consider, if you will, a blank canvas. How often has this world told us that we are lost in a dark world that offers us no hope? And often we feel the pressures of life starting to close in. Often we feel like there's no way out. I'm here to let you know that's a lie. Even in your darkness, God has a plan. Even in your lack of hope, God has a plan. Even when you feel counted out, God has a plan. You are not alone today.
Misfits, rejects, losers, defects, weirdos, awkward, broke down, strange kids. Don't you forget, you are loved, you are loved. And this is for black kids, white kids, dark kids, light kids, wrong kids, right kids. Every kid I write this, that. Don't you forget, they are loved, they are loved. Welcome to the island of the misfit toys. Welcome to the island of the misfit toys. Welcome to the island of the misfit toys. Land of the broken girls and boys.
You're not alone today. Notice how the darkness covered up the fact that we miss that Jesus says that we are loved. So often we get distracted. So often we can't see him through our darkness. And that's just a painting. God is very real. He speaks to our heart. He tells you that you have purpose, that you have life, that you are a winner. Where the whole world said that you're losing, you can't make it. Every misfit, every reject, every loser, every defect, you are loved today with an incredible love. If you believe that, make some noise. This is for the misfits, rejects, losers, defects, weirdos, awkward, broke down, strange kids. Never forget that you are loved.
You are loved. You are loved.
This is for the black kids, white kids, dark kids, light kids, wrong kids, right kids. Every kid I write this at, they don't forget that
you are loved. You are loved. You are loved.
Welcome to the island of the misfit toys, where God puts the broken back together. Amen. Aren't you glad that he puts the broken back together today? All right, so Tommy made me do this. I'm okay with it. He said, well, you know, you guys set the Guinness World Record for freestyling. It still stands right here in this building. Now, you don't know what I'm talking about. That's okay. Let me explain. For 13 hours, we stood on this stage. We used the gift of improvisational freestyle rap. Never to cuss, never to want to put down women, never to tell anybody how great we are, but to talk about and brag on our Jesus. 13 hours straight. And so, it's a long time to do that. So we had to kind of.
It was a long day.
But our record still stands to this day to the glory of God. So I thought we'd give you just a little taste of what they might have experienced back then, okay?
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a good friend of mine. His name is Rubox Cube. He's going to take you on a little beatbox journey, okay? You ready? Let's go. I'm going to come follow how he goes. Maybe we'll come out and say hi to you guys. You ready?
Yeah, go ahead. Now, here we go. Clap your hands from the top of the show. Everybody, you can see me when I slam ya and make some noise if you down out from Tampa. That's the sport. I could break it down. We got people just from New York. Yep. And you can see me while I'm speaking. We got Caribbean, Haitian, Jamaican, plus some Puerto Ricans. You know just what I'm doing. Shout out to my people in the back, and they from Cuba. Yep. So here we go, just on the spot, and I'ma keep it rocking, and you know it's never stopping now. Yep. And you can see me while I flow again. Make some noise for your pastor, Tamami Groningen. Man, I said it wrong. Let's rewind that junk. Let's try it in this song. Okay, now I gotta say right now, I was a jerk. Four songs in, we ain't never gave away the shirt. Should we get the shirt out just right now? Why don't you throw it in the crowd? Come on, let's step off the stage. Let's see the people, no matter just what the age. Yeah, and you can see me while I clap. If they want a t-shirt, well, they really got to clap. There you go. Keep it out clapping. What happened? I just vapped while I'm rapping. Hold up. I flow now with stamina. I gotta stop and just say hi to the camera. Man, you know I mean no pity. Little white boy, he was grown in Ybor City. And you know just what I'm doing, cause the best food we get right here is a Cuban. Hold up, no need to stress. If you want a Cuban sandwich, make sure it's pressed. That's for their mommy. Forget about Miami, cause we only rock salami. Yep. They know just what I mean. I need a double crab right there and a little cheese that goes on the spot. And every time I'm slamming the, man, I'm so Tampa, I remember Dale Mabry. See me while I blast ya. Back before MLK was known as Nebraska. Yeah. And you know just what I see, cause I'm always staying down with the 813. Man, I keep it clear. Back the orange jerseys were on the Buccaneers. Man, that's kinda nerdy, but man, I'm over 30. I remember Vinny Testaverde. Okay, now here we go. Stop that beat, man, that's enough with the flow. Thank you very much, man, it's time for me to go. Give out the shirt, bro. Peace out, God bless, yo.
Oh my God, I'm crying. Oh, oh my God, we're going to the Super Bowl! Yeah! Woo! Woo! Woo!
Yeah, baby, let's go Super Bowl, let's do it!
Let's go, crew!
Number two Super Bowl.
Yeah, right.
We're going to the Super Bowl, baby! We're going to the Super Bowl!
Woo!
We're going home for the Super Bowl.
By any means, man.
Let's go. By any means. No matter how we get it done. It don't matter.
As long as we get done.
Oh, yeah.
Tampa! Tampa!
Bruce, one quick message for the folks back in Tampa.
We're coming home, and we're coming home to win.
Yeah. Come on, y'all, make some noise for our city, our Bucks. Yeah. Listen, y'all, our city has made history. I mean, we are the first city ever to be hosting the Super Bowl and have our very own team in the Super Bowl. I see that flag over there. Check them out. Yeah, yeah, yeah. On top of that, we're like the first city ever to host a Super Bowl during a pandemic, right? That's crazy. On top of that, But here's the crazy thing about our city's winning streak. It's not just with the Bucks. I mean, all four of our professional sports teams have made it to the finals. Y'all realize that? So we got the Tampa Bay Rays. Come on, we got to give it up for the Rays. They went to the World Series. Yeah. I mean, you know, they didn't make it, but they got to the World Series. That's something, right? That's the Lightning, go Bolts. They won the Stanley Cup. They did it. Yeah. And then if y'all follow soccer, I don't even follow soccer that much, but the Rowdies, the Tampa Bay Rowdies, they were in the finals as well. And so now we got the Bucks in the Super Bowl, all four teams. Listen, that has only happened one other time in history when a city had all four teams go to the finals. And of course, that's the second greatest city in the world. That's where I grew up at. That's Philadelphia, baby. Yeah. So if y'all didn't know, I'm from Philly. So back in 1980, I was a little kid. I was there in the city. All four of our teams went to the finals, but only one of them won, and that was the Philadelphia Phillies. They won the World Series in 1980. I remember the city went bananas. So listen, tonight, if the Bucks win, that's going to be another record, y'all. That's going to be two of our professional sports teams out of all four that are going to win. So how many of y'all think they're going to win tonight, y'all? All right, y'all ready, man? Y'all excited? Listen, so here's the thing, y'all. As you can see, it's super rare what has happened during a pandemic here in our city. But on top of that, it's not just our sports teams, but in so many other ways, like our city's winning. Our city's winning, y'all. In 2020, Tampa Bay was the number one vacation destination in the United States. It was. We beat out Orlando. We beat out Miami. Of course, we beat New York City because everybody had to quarantine for 2 weeks. That's why plane tickets were $12, because nobody was like, I got to go there. I can't go anywhere, right? So in a time when so many cities are watching businesses leave and close, like God has been blessing our city, there have been several major relocations with big companies that have come here and they're bringing thousands of jobs. So our economy has been like blessed in a lot of ways compared to a lot of other places, y'all. So, I mean, that's something to be thankful for, y'all. And so on top of that, like, our church has been winning. Our church has been solid. Our church has been stable, y'all. We've been able to serve more people in this pandemic than we ever have before. You know, every week we do our grocery drive-through. We partner with Feeding Tampa Bay. We've been able to give out food every week. Our Love Our City projects have been doing so many things throughout the year. We've been able to reach thousands of new people that are worshiping with us online. Give it up for all the people worshiping with us online. Listen, to those of you worshiping online with us, we apologize. The internet went down this week. They've been trying to work on it and fix it, so it's been going in and out a little bit, but we love y'all. It's going to be good by next week, right? But every week, we've seen thousands of people, new people connect with us online, here in person since we reopened the doors. We've literally had hundreds of new people walk through the doors in the past couple months. Every single week, there's been new people starting relationships with Jesus or getting reconnected with Jesus. People taking their next steps in Christ, people growing, people being generous. I mean, so many incredible things have been happening, and God has been in control, y'all. God's been in control through it all. He's been taking care of us. And so I want to thank you guys for your generosity, because you know what? Our church has stayed stable, and really that's just a testament because so many people in our church have been stable. There's so many people that some people lost jobs, they got better jobs. Some people started new businesses during this pandemic. Some people got promotions. I mean, some people paid off debt. Some people reached new goals. Some people were just stable, and praise God for stability right now, right? 2020 was actually Crossover Church's best year ever financially. And so we give God some praise for that in the middle of a pandemic. And so in 2021, our goal is to give more away to the city, to the community, to the world, more than we've ever given before, right? Where much is given, much is required. And we're gonna love our city, we're gonna love our world, show them Jesus this year more than ever before. So really quick, before we start this service, I mean, I know the pandemic has been challenging, there's been some pain, and I get all that. But for a minute though, we've heard all the bad news, we need to talk about some good news. Because there is a lot of good stuff that we can point to and God has been blessing his people and taking care of his people, right? And we've been a big part of that. There's been a lot of wins for our city, for our church, in so many ways. So for like 15 seconds before I start this message officially today, I want you to go crazy like Tom Brady scored the last touchdown and the Bucks won tonight. I want you to go crazy and give God some praise for about 15 seconds. Y'all ready? Come on, crossover. 1, 2, 3. Come on. Give God some praise. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. Woo. All right, y'all can be seated. Let's pray. God, we love you today. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. God, if we're on your team, we're on the winning team all day, every season. And so, God, we just pray over these next couple of minutes, those that are with us here in the building, those that are worshiping with us online. God, help us just to focus in to what you want to say to us today about winning and about how to get into a winning rhythm in 2021, God. So just use me as your mouthpiece today. Use your word over these next couple of minutes. We thank you that we could come to church and, man, we could have fun. We thank you for a place like this where we could really be us and we could celebrate you, God. And so we're a place where people can meet you and grow in you. And so, God, we thank you for Crossover Church. We thank you for all the wins, all the blessings, even in the middle of a hard time. God, you've still been taking care of your people. And so, God, we acknowledge that today, and we thank you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Everybody said, yeah. Come on, make some noise for the Lord, y'all. So throughout the month of January, we have been doing this series called Rhythm, and that's our word for 2021. And we've been taking a look at the life of the prophet Elijah from the Old Testament, from the book of 1 Kings. And we've been kind of walking through his story each week. And so each week we kind of called it, instead of a week or a part, we called it a beat. So beat one, we talked about our spiritual rhythm. Beat two, we talked about our mental health rhythm. Beat three, we talked about our vision rhythm. Beat four, I preached from a treadmill up here. Y'all remember that? And we talked about physical health rhythm. Beat five, we talked about legacy rhythm. And last week was a special, special day as our founding pastor came back. He came from Atlanta, Pastor Joe McCutcheon, and he preached. And you guys honored my wife and I for being here for 25 years, and I can't believe it's been that long. Thank you guys for your thank yous, your cards. Thank you for all you guys that sent an email into that email. We read every single one of them, and some of them were like a book, but they were amazing. So many just great stories, and man, so heartfelt. Me and Lucy, man, we love y'all. We love y'all. So after 25 years, I feel good, y'all. I feel like I'm in a winning rhythm. So today on Super Bowl Sunday, when it's in our city, our team is in it, we're going to talk about winning rhythm, which I think is so fitting for this historic moment in time. And so we're going to look at the last part of Elijah's life, which personally is like my favorite. So I told Pastor Christopher, I'm like, man, I'm glad Pastor Joe didn't talk about that part last week, because I'm gonna wrap it up and finish it up today, talk about it. And so it's when he gets restored. Remember, like, he was running from Jezebel. He was, like, depressed. He was suicidal. This is when he gets restored, and he follows God's play for the big win. And so 1 Kings 19, Elijah, he ran away because Queen Jezebel put this hit out on his life. The mob was out to get him. There was hitmen literally coming to get him. He is running for his life. He's discouraged. He's depressed. He literally, the Bible says, he was at a point where he was suicidal. He was like, God, just take my life. I'm done. I quit. I can't do this anymore. What? The prophet, the man of God, Elijah? Like really? He was ready to give up? Yeah. But listen, God didn't give up on him. So the Bible tells us that he sent an angel that brought some food for him. He got re-strengthened. He got restored. He got renewed. And he was ready for what was next. And God gave him that next play. And so listen, I want to tell you today, just like God didn't give up on the prophet Elijah, even when he was like ready to give up everything, God's not giving up on you. God's not giving up. I know some of you, you've been in a losing rhythm. Yeah, you shouted and yelled a little bit ago for the Bucks and for our city and for our church, and that's great. But you personally feel like you've been taking a lot of L's. You personally may feel like, man, I've been in this losing rhythm in my life. A lot of things haven't gone right. And, you know, I feel like God gives me these plays and I mess it up and I can't just seem to get it right. I want to tell you today that God's not done with you yet. God's not going to cut you from the team. God's not going to permanently sit you on the bench. I'm here to tell you today, whether you're worshiping online or whether you're right here in this building wearing a Bucks jersey today, I'm here to tell you today, God has not forgotten about you. God loves you. God has a plan for you. He's got hope for you. He's got a future for you. He's got another play for you. He's got some wins for you. If you believe that, make some noise in this house, in your house. Yeah, let's go. So look at somebody and say, get in the game. Look at the other person next to you and say, get in the game. Right? Even if you're at home, say, get in the game. Type it in the chat. Get in the game. Right? So Elijah, he got back in the game. Yeah, he was out in the game for a minute, but God restored him. He got back in the game after he had his little pity party. He had one there in scripture, we see. So he got back in the game. God said, go up to the mountain. I'm going to talk to you. And God showed up on the mountain, gave him his next instructions, and he gave him his next play. Look at what God's next play was, starting in verse 15. It says, then the Lord told him, go back the same way you came and travel to the wilderness of Damascus. And when you arrive there, anoint Hazael, anoint him to be the king of Aram. Then anoint Jehu, the grandson of Nimshi, the king of Meshola. Then anoint Elijah of Shaphat from the town of Ebro-Meshola and replace you as my prophet. Did you catch that? Did you catch that last part? God was telling him to anoint somebody else to replace him. Wait, what? Like, hold up. Like, I want y'all to take some notes today, whether you're at home or whether you're in the house here across over, pull out the app, or if you got an old school like notebook, paper and pen, that's cool too. What can we learn from this play that the Most High coach just gave? A couple of things we can learn. Number one is this: we're called to the team for life, but our positions will change. You're called to God's team for life, but guess what? Your positions are gonna change. Our assignments are temporary. I know this guy named Christopher Harris, he wrote a book about that. It's really good, you should get it. Temporary assignments. So you're called to God's team, his family for life, but your position is going to change, and probably it's going to change multiple times during the course of your life. So I've been here across over 25 years now, and as I look back, my position has changed multiple times. When I came, I started the youth ministry, me and my wife. And my plan for God, you ever had a plan for God? How'd that work out for you? Right, so my plan was like, I'm gonna be the youth pastor until I die, right? And so I was doing youth ministry, God was moving, great things were happening. And then I kind of went into this role a little bit, like I was sort of like the associate pastor too, trying to help the pastor because he wanted to quit multiple times. And I'm like, no, come on, you gotta keep going. I'm here to help you. He's like, why don't you take over? No, let me help you, right? I did not want to be the pastor. I was fighting it for a while. And so I started doing some of the preaching on Sundays. I was organizing stuff. And then soon he was like, see, like, just take over. And so then, beginning of 2002, I reluctantly stepped into that position. I'm like, I'll do this for a little while until we find the next person where we're looking for him. A few months later, I was like, I think we found him. All right. So then I moved into being the lead pastor, but I was still doing the youth ministry. For like another 3 years, I was doing like both. Then eventually found somebody and I was able to finally like, you know, just be the lead pastor. But you're never just the lead pastor, right? Not a crossover. You do like a whole bunch of different things. And so I know that even over the course of the rest of my life, it's gonna continue to change. Guess what? In 25 years from now, I'm not gonna be the lead pastor at Crossover Church anymore. I'm gonna have found my replacement. I don't know, I may still be around doing something. I'm gonna be doing seniors ministry or something then. I don't know if it's God's will, but you know. So the bottom line is your position is gonna change on the team. And you gotta learn to accept that whenever God says, this is the next play, right? Here's the second thing we see. Empower others to do what you do. Don't like hold on to it so tightly, like, nah, this is mine. I don't want anybody to start to get good at this because then I'm gonna lose my spot on the team. Like, oh man. Like, listen, even now, I'm the lead pastor, but many Sundays you'll see somebody else up here preaching because we have a team model here, because it's not just about one person, right? And there's many Sundays, especially pre-pandemic, I wasn't even here. I'm preaching at some other church. I'm traveling somewhere else. And when I'm gone, everything runs fine because it doesn't revolve around one person. I've empowered other people to regularly, our other pastors, our staff, other voices. I mean, man. Like, listen, you need to raise other people up to do what you do, if you're healthy. But once you get healthy and you're in rhythm with God, part of that rhythm is empowering other people. How many of y'all can agree this world needs more good leaders? And when you become a good leader, you want to train the next person up to be a good leader as well, so they can do exactly what you do. And prayerfully, and this is my prayer, the next person that comes along at Crossover and takes over being the lead pastor, I pray that they take it to a whole nother level. Yes. Not that like, oh, it goes down and everyone's like, oh man, we miss Urban D. You know, like, no, I pray that like the next person comes someday, whenever that is, and it's just like it goes through the roof then. Right? I can get out the way and empower somebody. Here's the third thing, y'all. When God gives a play, learn to fully obey. You know, I like the rhyme. When God gives a play, learn to what obey? Fully. Somebody say fully. Type fully in the chat. Because listen, most plays, they have an expiration point. Like they're gonna expire, right? When Coach Bruce, when he gets the Bucks together on a timeout and everybody huddles up, right? And he's talking about the next play, he's drawing out this is what's gonna happen right now. He's not talking about a play that's gonna happen in the next quarter. He's not talking about a play that's gonna happen in 20 minutes. He's talking about a play that's gonna happen right now. So if Tom Brady's like doing a play that was from like, you know, 30 minutes ago, that's not gonna work anymore because that's not the setup. Everything has changed, right? So when God gives you a play for right now, like do it. How many of y'all have ever like missed a play from God because you waited, right? You delayed, you were like, oh, well, I'm gonna get around to it. Yeah, and then you lost the win and you're like, ah, oh, man, what was I thinking? Listen, write this down. Delay is disobedience. Delay can quickly become disobedience. When God gives a play, obey, do it now. So we see that's what Elijah did. Look at verse 19, check it out. It says, so Elijah went and he found Elijah. Now notice they're two different people. I used to get them mixed up when I was a kid back in the day. Elijah is the prophet, right? Elijah is this new guy, right? That he's gonna recruit him and train him to replace him, right? So Elijah went and found Elijah, son of Shaphat, plowing the field. There were how many teams of oxen in the field? 12. And Elijah, he was plowing with the 12th team, so he was like in the back chilling, right? And so Elijah went over to him and threw his cloak across his shoulders, and then he just walked away. Elijah left the oxen standing there and ran after Elijah. And then he said, first, let me go and kiss my mother and my father and say goodbye, and then I'll go with you. So Elijah replied, okay. Go on back, but think about what I have just done to you. So Elisha returned his oxen and he slaughtered them. And he used the wood from his plow to build a fire to roast their flesh. He passed around the meat to all the town people and they all ate. Then he went with Elijah as his assistant. Wow, give it up for Elijah for like following through with the play, doing what he was supposed to do, right? Now, there's so much great stuff in these verses. So God gave this play to Elijah, the prophet, and told him to go and anoint his replacement. God told Elijah, like, hey, man, your last season to play, it's coming up. And so we gotta get ready to train up your replacement, somebody that's going to be the quarterback prophet and hold it down, right? And so, you know what? He obeyed. A lot of people don't obey when they get that play, do they? You see a lot of even sports players, they play past their prime, right? And then everybody's like, they're embarrassed for them. You know, they're like, oh man, I don't even want to wear the jersey anymore, you know? Because they just start doing so bad, they just don't want to stop playing, right? And eventually they get cut and it kind of ends on a sour note. But guess what? Pastors do that sometimes too. There's a lot of pastors that don't want to let it go, and they just want to preach until they die, and the congregation, over time, it just goes down because they needed to pass the baton to the next generation, to somebody else to take it on. So that happens in church, too. It happens with artists. It happens in so many different career fields where somebody just doesn't want to let go, and it's time to let go because God has the next play and the next season. You got to learn to be okay with that. So it's crazy because Elijah, his replacement, he woke up that morning, and guess what? He had no idea what was about to happen to him. I mean, he was just going out to the field to plow. I mean, that's what he did every day. I mean, it was just kind of a mundane job. He would jump on the plow, and he would just be rolling around. And then along comes this prophet, this famous prophet, God's quarterback. He was known for dropping spiritual bombs on people. Elijah just shows up on the field, and everybody's like, oh, snap, look who it is. Like, and he just rolls up, and he's got his cloak, and he just rolls up, and he cloaks. He cloaks Elijah, and then he just keeps walking. And then Elijah comes and chases him, and he's like, what should I? You gonna come chase me, bro? All right, sit down. He comes and chases him, and he says, Elijah, hold on, wait a minute. Like, let me go say goodbye to my family. And so the prophet says, all right, go ahead and do that, but think about what I just did to you. And what did he do? In essence, he just rode up on him, and he gave him that Bucks jersey, and he said, you're drafted. You're on the team. You're on the team. And what did Elisha do? He obeyed. He obeyed that next play. He wasn't afraid. He wasn't like, oh my gosh, I'm not ready for this. Can we talk about it? Like, Elijah was out. He was like, all right, just meet me over here. Go do what you got to do, right? And so when I've read this passage and started studying it, you know, back in the day, at first it kind of confused me a little bit, part of it. Because if you look at this passage, like, what happens is he goes back, and the scripture tells us that he takes his oxen, that was the way he made his living, and he slaughtered them. He killed them. But I can get that one, Pastor Christopher, because he wanted to have a barbecue. He wanted to have a going away party with his crew and, you know, have a little barbecue tailgate party, you know, before he headed out, right? So I get that part. But the part that always kind of confused me before was the part about he burned his plow. Because I'm a pastor, but I also am wired in this way to be an entrepreneur as well. So the entrepreneur part of me is like, wait a minute, that wasn't good business sense. Because he could have took the plow down to the pawn shop. You know, he could have got a little bit of money for it, for the tour that he was about to go on with the prophet, you know. And then the other part of me is like, or you know, maybe he just could have held it, gave it to his parents, and they could have held it in the garage and just held it there in case the prophet gig didn't really work out. You know what I'm saying? Like, that would be the safe thing to do, right? And that's the key thing, y'all, the safe thing. But Elijah wasn't out to do the safe thing. And that's our problem. A lot of times we want to do the safe thing, and God gives us a play, but we have three other alternative plays. Or God gives us a play, we try to mix it in with our play and remix it a little bit, and then we wonder why we take a L. We did a little bit of it, and we're like, well, God, but God's like, nah, you switched up the whole play, and you messed it up, because I told you this, but yet you never let go of the other stuff. And so the bottom line is, Elijah was like, there's no other options for any other place. There's no plan B. There's nothing to come back to. I'm burning my plow. I'm killing my oxen. I'm going with the prophet, and I'm going to the next play. Some of y'all need to hear that word today, y'all. You need to hear that word because you've been holding back. You've got all these other plays in your back pocket, and you've been going by the playbook of the world, and God is saying, no, I got a playbook for you. I got a word for you. I got a next play for you. Don't miss it. And left and right, we see people missing God's plays, God's word. Listen, so write this down, y'all. Last thing to write down in your notes. When the almighty coach of the universe gives you a play, it's not to be played with. It's not to be played with, y'all. Don't mess with it. Many times, the reason we don't win is because we don't fully commit, right? So family, the way we get in a winning rhythm is when we 100%, somebody say 100. When we 100%, when we follow God's playbook, God's next specific plan that he has for you and me. And all of you, you're here today because guess what? God's spirit drew you here, whether you're worshiping with us online or you're physically right here in this building. And you know what? If I had a jersey, oh, look, Trent folded it up real nice. He's like, yeah, I got it. I'm going to give it back, man. It's yours. It's okay. He was like, oh, no, right? If I had a jersey for every single one of you, I would. And I would just come up to every single one of you guys and say, you're drafted to the team. Because God has drew you in for this moment on this historic day in this historic city for this historic time, right? To let you know he hasn't forgotten about you. You're invited to the team. And I know many of you, you're already on the team, but some of you that are here, you quit the team. And God's saying, come on back to the team. Some of you, maybe you've never signed up for the team, and God today is saying, I'm drafting you. And for those of you that are on the team, God is saying, I want you to follow the playbook 100%. And so I want to pray for you guys today, around the room, in your room, at home, if everybody could just bow their heads for a moment, and I want to pray for you today. If you're here today or you're worshiping online, and you could admit that, man, I don't know where I'm at with God. I don't know if I'm on the team. I don't know what's next for my life. I don't know the plan for my life. God is here right now. God is there right now, wherever you're at, wherever this is being streamed to, and God's telling you, I got a plan for you. I want you on my team. I want to draft you today, Super Bowl Sunday, February the 7th, 2021. I want to draft you. I got a jersey for you with your name on it. I got a playbook with plans for you that are going to blow your mind. All we have to do is we have to submit and say yes. Yes, I'll join the team. Yes, I'm not going to follow my own plays and my own plans, but I'm going to follow my Heavenly Father, the ultimate coach of the universe. I'm going to follow his playbook of what he has next because he knows best. If you're here today and you would say, Pastor Tommy, that's me. I need to get back on the team. I need to join the team. If you're here in this room, I just want you to slip your hand up really quick if that's you. You're saying, man, I want to be on the team. I want to make sure I'm on the team. I see you. If you're in the chat, you could put pray for me in there. We'll pray for you as well. We got some people in the chat that'll reach out to you guys as well. I want to pray for you guys in just a moment and walk you through a prayer. Secondly, I want to talk to everybody who's already on the team. The team meaning like God's family. If you're already on the team today, maybe you've been struggling with following through with the plays all the way. Maybe you've been trying to mix some of your own plays into it. Maybe you've been just missing the plays totally because you've been a little bit disobedient at times. If you can be man enough or woman enough to admit, yeah, I need to follow God's playbook a lot better. If that's you today, I want you to raise your hand. I want to pray for you guys as well in a moment. Awesome. Thank you guys for your honesty. Awesome. Let me pray for those of you, the first group that said, I want to make sure I'm on the team. Just pray this prayer with me. Say, Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for Jesus. He gives me the invitation to be on the team. I could be on the team because of what he did on the cross. He died for my sins, died for my mistakes, died for my disobedience. And so today, Super Bowl Sunday, 2021, I say yes, I submit. I wanna be on the team. I wanna follow your plays, God. Your playbook, show me what's next. Give me the strength and the courage to follow you, take my next steps. In Jesus' name. I want to ask everyone to stand up around the room. And if you're here, and a whole bunch of hands went up a moment ago, but if you're here again, and you would admit like, man, I need to do better at following God's plays. I want you to raise your hand. I want to pray for you guys. Father, I come before you. I pray for my team, my fellow teammates that are in this room and in rooms all over this city and rooms all over this country. God, we've all messed up when you've given us plays before and we've done our own thing. We haven't executed them right. And we've taken some L's. God, I pray that as we get back on the field of life this week, even as we leave this building or as we leave our home at some point, God, I pray that we're going to follow your playbook moving forward. We're going to make sure we follow every instruction, every pass, that we won't drop it. But God, I pray for spiritual touchdowns for real. I pray for wins in people's families, in their marriages, relationships with their kids. Pray for victories, God, over addiction, victories over depression, victories over anxiety, victories over sickness, victories over COVID. God, I pray in Jesus' name for healing in every area that people need it, God. And ultimately, God, we want to be in rhythm with you. If we're in rhythm with you, that's a winning rhythm. May not feel like we're winning every single day, but God, if we're following your playbook to a T, we're winning. And we know if we're on your team, we're going to have victory. We're going to have victory in Jesus' name. So God, bless every person, the sound of my voice, one that's watching this live or on the replay. Father, be with us. May they see our jerseys shining through in everything that we do, that we're on your team and we're representing you. May it draw people to you, and may we point them to you, that you're the answer. God, we lift all these things up before your throne today. In Jesus' name, everyone said, amen, amen. Come on. Come on, make some noise like the Bucks just made a touchdown. Come on, crossover. Yeah. Yeah. Listen, family, we love you guys today. It's going to be a fun day. It's going to be an amazing day. Yeah. Somebody say next Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Next Sunday, we are starting a brand new series. It's February. Valentine's Day is next Sunday. Love is in the air. So we're starting a new series, and we're going to be talking about relationships and sex. Starting a new series next Sunday called The Best Sex Ever. Yeah, we're going to talk about it in church. So, yeah, make sure you don't miss next Sunday. Invite some people to come or worship with us online. It's going to be amazing. But we thought today that we would maybe end service out with on a high note, with a bang. I mean, it was a high note now. A bunch of people just said yes to Jesus, joined the team, right? But we had a lot of fun today at church. But we're going to end out with one more song, okay? So this is a song, actually, that is a vintage classic song from like 20 years ago. Literally, this song released in 2001, and me and KJ52 did this song. And guess what? He reminded me today that we've actually never performed it before in person. Music video came out for it. Lots of people saw it. Lots of radio stations played on it. But we never actually performed it together. So 20 years later, we're finally going to do that today. Y'all cool? So come on. Give it up for my man KJ52 coming back out. I got to get a microphone, man. I can't rap with the earpiece. I'm going to feel.
There we go. All right. I don't promise I know every lyric, so I'm going to know half of every lyric.
It's okay, man. I got you, bro.
All right.
It's going to be
21 years they've been waiting for this. No, they haven't.
Well, here we go. Y'all ready? Crossover church. So I came up with this crazy idea. I said, why don't we just do like a whole bunch of like similes? Like this is like that, and this is like that, and this is a song that never been done like that before. So KJ was crazy enough to be like, all right, I'll do it. I'll do it with you. Cool. All right. So you ready, man?
Let's do it, man.
So we were the urban cleaning service.
That's right.
That's
yeah.
What this video is about. So we used to go out and clean houses together. We were broke rappers, broke youth pastors.
Mente Rosa.
So that was our side hustle back in the day. So in one of our jobs that we were doing, we decided to shoot this music video. So go ahead and run that, y'all. Here we go. Yeah, look at those outfits, man.
Look how tiny. Oh my gosh.
I was lost in this world, thinking I was alright.
B-boy moves, turntables,
and the mic.
Down inside I was searching,
till I saw the light and found Christ.
He was eternal life. I was lost in this world,
thinking I was alright.
B-boy moves, turntables, down inside I was searching,
till I saw the light. It's now me and Christ. We go together like chicken and teriyaki, Greeks and Slovakia, Canadians and ice
hockey.
Like coming to Kawasaki, like Philadelphia hockey. Spinal limit is jockey, like lift the weights and get stocky. Yo, like 30 dollars and cocky.
We go together like Davidson and Harley, or dreadlock, Rastafari, listening to Bob Marley. Better yet, it's like the headache that you tend to get looking at a broke TV set. Can't make sense of it. Me and Christ is like some fat bag jeans and bikes, fat baggy jeans and Nikes, or some head beans and lights. See what I mean to write is that now it's me and Christ. We go together like Adidas with the three stripes.
Like coffee and mugs, exterminators and bugs, socks and thugs, street corners and thugs, past fights, milk and jugs, grandmothers and hugs, Eskimos and gloves. We go together like homicide scenes and slugs.
I was lost in this world,
thinking I was a hype.
B-boy moves, turntables, but down inside I was searching,
and I saw the light. And now relationship with Christ
equals eternal life.
I was lost in this world, thinking I was a hype.
B-boy moves, turntables, but down inside I was searching,
and I saw the light. Cause now me and Christ, we go together.
Yo, Macho's mom is here.
Mom is here.
Mom is here.
Mom is here.
Eric B, Showbiz and AG,
your vibe bass and DJ Easy,
like some hip hop from 83 to 93, talking about EPMD, P-Dawg, BDP.
We go together like joints and elbows,
pipes and shell toes, dicks and afros,
mics ripped with fat flows,
sad shows and tears, fat flows and gear, getting mad over here.
Like architects and floor plans, the industry and sound scans, hot weather and fans, the Caribbean and white sands, like Woodstocks and rock bands, tips and spray cans, alligators and swamplands, like the whole world in his hands, like B-boys and shell toes, friends and foes, highs and lows, romance and a rose, uppercuts and blows, bunions and toes,
see, it's been a while.
And John Doe's like MCs and
some. Alright, here we go, here we go.
Flows. I was lost in the world, thinking I was a hype.
B-boy moves, turntables, but down the side I was searching,
and I saw the light and found relationship with Christ
equals eternal life.
I was lost in this world, thinking I was a hype.
B-boy moves, turntables, but down the side I was searching,
and I saw the light. It's now me and Christ, we go together like Mexicans and sombreros, 15 and quinceañeros, Taco Bell and Toqueros, Ruiz and Perros.
We go together like Robin and Batman, Marman and Batman, fat lips and swing hands, fat kicks and Van Damme. It's on the screen. Smiley face on a happy man.
Pencils and erasers, tornadoes and storm chasers, crack rocks and faces like elastic glaciers.
We go together like Jordan with the Michael, prayer with the Bible, Urban with disciple. And NyQuil, a big will, a big scrill. Thinking he's really ill, but really needs to chill.
Fight on rice, gamblers and dice, five easy beat out rice, dark hair and lights, Miami and vice, sugar and spice, cat spice, two times and twice, on point precise, like
success and God's advice. I got that one. B-boy moves, turntables, but down the side I was searching,
and I saw the light, and found relationship with Christ
equals eternal life.
I was lost in this world, thinking I was a hype.
B-boy moves, turntable, but down the side I was searching,
I saw the light. Cause now me and Christ, we go together like I was lost in this world, thinking I was a hype.
B-boy moves, turntables, alright. Look, that's the old crossover. Look at that.
That's the old crossover. Ready? Ready? Gonna catch me?
But down inside I was searching, I saw the light. Cause now me and Christ, we go together like.
Look at those guys right there. Those young guys.
Look, I used to be young. I used to be young at one point.
Crossover fam, make some noise for Jesus today. Hey, KJ52 is going to be out in the lobby. If you want to say what's up to him, he's going to be out there. He's got a table. If you want to get some, if you still listen to CDs, he's got some shirts and some merch out there, but he'll be out there hanging out. We're going to go out with our mission statement one time. We want to send you out to be winners, to live life in 3D. So let's go ahead and read this together on the count of three. Y'all ready? One, two, three. To empower people to discover, develop, and display Jesus Christ in every area of our lives. God bless you guys. We're going to dismiss section by section. Peace to everybody at home. We love y'all.
amazing tailgate Sunday that was. We had to call an audible, y'all. It was bad weather. We had to bring it inside, but that did not change the spirit of God that was in this place and the fun that we had. Y'all, we were jamming this morning. So we hope that we can catch you next week. Remember that you are loved. You are loved. You are loved. No matter who you are, where you come from, you are loved. We want to see you guys win this week. And this evening, if you're celebrating for the Super Bowl, remember to be safe, you guys. Wear your mask, social distance, but have a great time. We love you so much, and we will see you next week.